Molinaro, and I'm the Assistant Vice Provost for Educational Effectiveness at UC Davis. GORP stands for Generalized Observation and Reflection Protocol. The basic premise of the tool is to help you understand what's happening in a learning environment. We know that instruction happens in many different ways. It can be in a large lecture format, small format, it can be in a laboratory format discussion, many, many different ways across the country. And we want to understand what's happening in that classroom. So we want to be able to make sure that the observations are non-judgmental and really matter of fact, seeing what's happening in that classroom. And then we want to have a way of sharing that information with the faculty and the administration to maximize active learning approaches.
The Generalized Observation and Reflection Platform, or GORP for short, is a way of taking the temperature of a classroom, seeing what's happening in the class, how much time is being spent in lecture or Socratic methods, how much time is being spent in active learning modes, how much time are students asking questions, are professors answering questions, how much time are professors posing questions to students. It's a way of looking at what's happening in a classroom. GORP is an online protocol-based observation platform. It's easy to train observers to do it. We're using undergraduates who are learning assistants. They then take 2 or 3 hours of training, and they're easily engaged in the classroom environment. These LAs then observe what's happening in 2-minute or continuous intervals, and at the end of that time, we collect all of the data from a series of observations, and that gives us an idea of what's happening in that classroom. We can also use it to look at what's happening in discussion sections or laboratories or a variety of learning environments. GORP is a very generalized platform that allows us to take objective measures of what's happening in class. There are many classes in which wonderful lectures are captivating and, you know, engaging in their audience, and that's an appropriate learning approach. And then there are many classes that want to use additional active learning, cooperative learning, project-based learning, and inquiry-based labs. Here's how GORP works. The picture you see in front of you is what an observer sees when they begin a classroom observation. On the left-hand side are a set of orange buttons that indicate what students are doing in the classroom. Top left indicates they'd be listening, or they're working independently, or asking or answering questions. Perhaps they're responding to clickers or doing group works. On the right-hand side are a set of green buttons that indicate what the instructor is doing. They can be lecturing, they can be writing, they can be posing clicker questions, or following up, or even doing one-on-one work. In the middle is a timestamp, and that timestamp represents right now 2-minute intervals so that we can analyze the data from what's happening in classroom on 2-minute intervals. And then finally at the bottom is the engagement level. If active learning's going on, is it low, medium, high engagement? Typically, we often don't even measure the engagement level. It's sufficient to understand the kinds of instructions that are going on. So, for example, let's say the class starts and the lecturer starts lecturing and perhaps is writing at a board. The students are listening, and that goes on for a little while. But perhaps also the professor stops lecturing and poses a clicker question. The students are then answering the clicker question. Every 2 minutes, the GORP resets and a new set of buttons and a new set of actions need to be recorded. So for example, perhaps the professor is again lecturing for this part of this 2-minute period, and then after that they go into, say, group work that is driven by things that the professor asks as a posed question, and then the professor can follow up with that group work later on. So this is a way of exploring and measuring and observing the kinds of actions that are happening in the classroom. Once the observation of a class is complete, the data can be displayed in several different ways. Here's a simple display of 2 different classes. On the top, we see what the student did during class 1. Students spent the entire class listening with a question asked in the early part of the class. The instructor spent the time lecturing and writing at the board and then answering that question that the student asked at the beginning. This is a traditional and lecture-based class. There's no discussion or evidence here of whether it was a fantastic lecture or perhaps not. But there's a good description in a time sequence of what the instructional type was. Down below in this slide, you actually see a different class where there's a lot more student-centered activity. Yes, there's lecturing and writing at the board, but there's also students asking questions, working in groups, and other kinds of activity. The same time, the instructor of that class is asking questions, guiding student work, and involved in some one-on-one interactions in the classroom. Here are two displays of different kinds of classrooms at Boston University taken in April 2015. On the top, you see an observer report of a traditional lecture. Going from right to left is the time sequence of the class, and you can see that most of the time is spent in lecturing or showing slides. There's an occasional question and answering that goes back and forth between the faculty member and the students. Down below is a much more interactive studio classroom. This classroom has 9 tables of 9 in a flat classroom design, and the actions in the class are designed around a peer instruction protocol. Here you can see that there's a fair amount more of group work, which is that bright red line at the bottom. There is instructor moving through groups, which is the pinkish color towards the bottom. The yellow indicates that there's clicker response and clicker questions that are going on, and the blue at the very bottom indicates that there is still some lecturing happening by the faculty member. So these observer reports can then be analyzed, and we can get a general picture of what happens in the classroom. They can be used in an aggregate to examine pre- and post-transformation of the class. They can help the faculty member feed back into whether or not they're reaching their goals and how they're doing instruction. And they can be used on an aggregate for a whole department or school to see how much active learning is going on in their classrooms. There have recently been some interesting publications using the COPUS protocol on the GORP platform in 256 classes by Marilyn Staines of the University of Nebraska-Lincoln and Travis Lund from Oregon Tech. They have demonstrated that using this protocol in 256 classes, that the clusters fall into several different categories, and it's a relatively straightforward process to then use the data that you see here in advancing discussions around teaching and learning. GORP is a way of assessing what you're trying to do in your class, not a way of judging whether it's effective or not. Using learning outcomes and other assessments, we can look at what's being valued in the class. But GORP is a way of really taking the temperature, providing a baseline, providing a comparison, and giving data to the instructor, the other professors in the department, and allowing that department to start a conversation about teaching and learning in large STEM courses.